Welcome back. Alright, so I think I'm supposed to go up here, right? Oh, yeah.
Well, if it ain't the talk of the town, poster child for Camarilla Benevolence. What errand does the prince have you running today?
Funny.
Nines is expected. Have some manners and don't wear out your weapon. Respect. Act up again, and I'll be the one showing your ashes to the door.
Like
so then go on up and see it. You're free to do as you please here.
I'll do that. Rude. I gotta talk to this guy first.
Look at who made it back in one piece. Out of Santa Monica, yo.
Eh. That was okay.
Yeah, I'm sure it was a stroll on the beach. Did you score a lot of skee ball tickets down the pier there?
Nope.
I can't imagine you did. I'll be too busy getting pushed around by every vampire with a week of seniority on you, am I right?
Pretty much.
That's usually the way the story goes. Same old bullshit politics from when you were alive. Don't it make you just want to rip somebody's spine out? What? Saying that's just me?
Oh, that's
it. Oh, really?
What's up with that?
The sarcophagus. Did LaCroix tell you about the Incarn sarcophagus?
Nope.
Yeah, well, maybe I should fill you in on the details. That sarcophagus is bad news. Kindred around the globe have been going batshit since it was discovered.
Why?
The word is there's an ancient asleep in there. One of the fathers, one of the vampires, that if you trace your lineage way back, there's a chance it'd end up with him at the roof.
He's asleep this whole time.
Ancients don't just nap. They sleep whole ages away. And when they wake up, they're hungry.
So
it's more than that, you know. Most kindred think it's one of the signs of the end, the apocalypse. Every religion has their own version of it. Kindred call it Gehenna, and the way they tell it, it starts when the ancients rise to devour their children.
I don't really believe this
well,
stuff.
Well, you know, I guess you're gonna be the one to find out. Hey, good luck. Try not to wake Grandpa Munster and kill the world, huh?
That's funny. Why is he sending me that?
I never thought you'd make it back. If Nines didn't stand up for you in the courtroom, you would have been toast right there, man. Everybody knows that.
Of course.
Public relations, man. Calculated risk. Ventura born in a courtroom. When Nines called him out, LaCroix realized it was time to show a carefully measured dose of Camarilla compassion.
Croy
is the boss of the Camarilla in L.A. That's it. LaCroix is the boss. That's rich.
You're not partying?
Free living dead, kiddo. A lot of people like to use the label anarchs. Whatever the hell that means. Anarchs. That's got a nice kick to it, though, huh?
Probably
thing. Like the Camarilla need us to buy in their bullshit for any of the laws to meet the day. Now, telling free-living vampires they need to be ruled is a hard sell. So, the Camarilla baked up a plain nicey plan. Show everyone how great they are, so we'll all just jump on board.
It's not working.
Kid, we lived in California, some of us, for over 100 years. We've kicked the Camarilla's ass out of town before. Seems like every time they smell blood, they're back trying to take over.
Run into
yeah, not a moment too soon, huh? You said you guys let those Sabat go too. Nines must be getting soft. How can you pass up that kind of farm?
I'll come and help me.
He was left sireless too. Oh, maybe that's it. He's got a thing for the little guy.
All right, I'm out of here.
You showed up. Good. Here's what I gotta tell you. And so you know, I don't lecture, I don't rap, I'm no bureaucrat. I'm just a guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me.
Go on.
You got a right to know the score. The Camarilla, this is the short of it. They operate a lot like a pyramid scheme. There's a bunch of these old timers at the top with God only knows what plots in mind. They lose their power, they die. They sired more to carry out their plans. I'm looking for a little power than those kindred sired for their own schemes, and so on and on and on. It hurts my head just thinking about the mess. And it works out to exist. Only a few people at the top have that real power.
Aren't you part of the Camarilla?
Those fighting words, maybe. But you're young and stupid, so I won't make an example out of you. See, the Camarilla claims all of us are members, even if we don't want to, which is, of course, the biggest little horseshit a man ever heard.
So what are you all about?
I learned the way of this world during the Depression. A bunch of old rich bastards screwed the country. But did they suffer? No. The little people suffered. You can't trust the people at the top. The world would be a better place without them. All you can do is get a group of people together who aren't assholes. Find a place to put your feet up and make some examples of the quote-unquote elite to keep the rest the hell out. Everyone's an equal here. The same thing this country used to be about. That's what LA has been. An anarch-free state.
Anarch-free state?
The Camarilla was kicked out on their ass a long time ago. We, the anarchs, didn't want to play their politics anymore. Now LaCroix and crew pop in like they never left? Uh-uh. No goddamn way. Their laws don't apply to us.
Have you tried meeting with them?
I got their meeting right here.
Not fun.
LaCroix represents everything I hate. The Camarilla, stuck-up aristocrats, rich businessmen, crooked politicians. The only place LaCroix belongs is in an arena.
Okay.
No such thing. And again, newbie, don't throw those kind of words around like you. You're risking a beat down. I fought to keep LA free since I was embraced. Long time later, I'm one of the only ones left that hasn't bitted or switched sides. The most veteran soldier on the battlefield. Here's what I tell all the new blood. One, you get careless, that blood will make you into a monster. But you rampage around here, you get put down. Two, don't kill when you feed. No reason to. In this city, there's lots of ways to slake the beast without leaving a trail of dead. Three, the Camarilla's full of shit. Four, watch your back, always. And lastly, learn how to fight. Because a speech ain't gonna save your ass when you're staring down the barrel of a shotgun.
True, but... thanks for all your help.
LA's the school of hard knocks, so keep your friends close and your enemies in a barbecue pit. Once you square things with LaCroix, don't give that son of a bitch the time of night. I got my eye on you, kid.
I'll do that, sure. Is there anyone else in here? No. Alright.
5 minutes later.
Let's stop that. Alright, let's see.
There's this girl who's been making a lot of noise lately. Real pain. She's a ghoul that is when Toreador creep would disappear. Yeah, Abby.
Oh.
You must know who I'm talking about. She used to show up around here and act like she was everybody's best friend. It was all fun and games until her vampire sugar daddy stopped calling her. Now she can't get her blood fixed and she ain't so fun. She's crossed the line. Only time that mouth ain't blabbing is with a sucking vampire blood. She's gotta disappear. Do this, and we'll keep it our little secret, you hear? All right, have fun. I'd love to do this one myself, but I know it's silent. Just let me know when it's done.
All right, I got a few more questions. Hopefully, he could freaking tell me something about this freaking... issue that's going on here.
You've got to understand, Kindred. You're carrying a 6,000-year curse in your blood. No matter how powerful it makes you feel, that blood is a tangle of chains that's going to leave you bound in servitude the rest of your existence. Your elders command the blood. color, they control the blood, and the blood listens. You'll never even hear their call. That shit stretches all the way back to Cain. Some ancient sleeping in a tomb half a world away has a bad dream, and you don't hear that shit. Father of all vampires. Killed his brother Abel and was cursed by God to walk eternity feeding on the blood of his children. Some heavy shit. Keep your voice down. Is Cain real? I don't know. Not sure I want to know. The point is, with this curse pulling your strings, you really want to sign away your right to fight by joining the Camarilla? Yeah? The Camarilla just ain't necessary. Their rules is just common sense shit. The masquerade and all that. Sure, it makes sense. Like the Ten Commandments. You know the Ten Commandments, don't you? Yeah, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill. Sounds good, but you and me both know that shit don't always go. What if some society like the Camarilla comes along and just up and kills you if you break one damn commandment? See, we weren't meant to live like that. I followed someone else's rules for 3 years in Vietnam, but it wasn't until after the embrace that I understood real oppression. Anarchs? We are the only ticket to free living in the afterlife. No one bows to Nazareth. He leads by example, down here with us. There's some cheap shit living his paper pusher hiding up in his tower.
Okay, none of this is helping me.
Sorry.
Okay, none of them have information on it, but I do have a quest for me, but that you can do that whenever I want, I think. Hold on, I think I've been doing it wrong. Okay, so okay. Oh, I can talk to you.
What do you want? Yeah? Well, I'd feel a lot more like talking if you gave me a few bucks, you know? How about a 20 to lubricate the old vocal cords?
Fine, okay. Whatever.
I mean, I don't know too much about nothing, but I know that Tin Can Bill's been telling some crazy stories about how he's got sick and all. Something about a monster or some such. You can usually find him down in his alleyway, just across from that bar nearby.
You mean this one? Nope. Wait, this is a bar right here. So maybe this one? Are you him? No. Are you? Oh, jeez.
Who's there, huh? Old Bill can't see too good these days. Is that you, Fred? I ain't got no booze tonight, so you may as well get the hell out of here. Yeah, I might be able to.
Oh, my God.
But I'm awful thirsty tonight, mister.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Just spare $5 for a man who's been down on his luck.
Sure, whatever. Okay.
Thank you. Oh my God. I'm going to have to go pick up some hooch. For medicinal purposes, you know.
Sure.
Now, I know you're going to believe old Bill, because I've been telling my friends and the cops and everyone since it happened. People just say that it's the hooch talking and nothing more.
Try, I believe you.
There's a monster, you see. Monster in a
his face all twisted and ugly, teeth longer than your finger, and these eyes piss yellow and full of hate. I've never seen eyes like that before. Still giving me bad dreams.
So what happened?
He grabbed me, threw me over his shoulder, took me to the bad place, the dark place. Oh, God. The smell. Worse than anything I've... And then he bit me. My neck. Oh, God. It was horrible. Don't remember too much after that. Blacked out and woke up here in my alley. Haven't been feeling too well since then.
Oh my God.
Came up through the sewers, he did. Just around the corner there. Don't want to go back to the bad place, man. Don't let the monster come back and take me there.
Oh shit, he died? Whoa. Damn. Was he talking about- yep, it was this one. Alright. Can you feed off this script? Take him. Oh, it's another one. Jeez. Oops, that's not. That's locked. Do I hear breathing? Hold on. Oh, what the heck? Don't go in there. Okay. That's where I came from, I think. Just eat the rats. I don't care. I need blood anyway, so. Especially if, since I'm gonna use blood buff. Probably. To open that stupid- ah! Oh. Oh. Can I open- nope, I cannot open that. I think I have to go through that door. I'm not 100% sure. It's been a long time, so I have no idea. Alright, let's try the... Yes! It's open! Okay. Ah. Oh. Don't go in there. Okay, let's go in here. Oh. All right. I think I'm gonna leave it here, and I'll see you all in the next one.